I'm Patience Aliyu with the NAN News highlights. President Muhammadu Buhari is in Katsina State for a two-day official visit. The president, at a visit to the palace of the Emir of Katsina, said the federal government would provide assistance to communities affected by the recent rainstorm and flood disaster, which killed 6 persons and damaged over 530 houses. Buhari is also expected to hold talks with the visiting Togolese president, Faure Eyadema, while in the state. The Minister of Labour and Employment, Senator Chris Ngige, says the federal government will review the newly introduced 500% excise duty on locally produced alcoholic beverages. Ngige said the move would save the sector from imminent collapse and forestall the consequent loss of about 200,000 jobs across the country. The International Press Institute has decried the killing of 5 newspaper employees at the offices of the Capital Gazette newspaper in the U.S. state of Maryland, calling it an attack against free journalism worldwide. An attacker on Thursday, June 28, armed with a shotgun and smoke grenades, forced his way into the paper's office, spraying the newsroom with bullets. The results of an advanced clinical trial have suggested that prostate cancer can be treated with single-dose radiotherapy rather than life-altering hormone therapy. The research conducted by the Peter MacCallum Cancer Centre in Australia had 33 trial patients tested with the new technique, stereotactic ablative body radiotherapy, which delivers an accurate dose of radiotherapy to tumor sites, controlling 93% of such cancer spots. And a new study of Italian centenarians has revealed that human longevity is slowly increasing and that, contrary to past reports, the maximum lifespan for a human has not been reached. Based on data from more than 3,800 centenarians in Italy, researchers found that human lifespan may increase over time due to socioeconomic factors and improved medical care. For details of this and other stories, log on to our website, nan.ng.